he's taking up the agenda of NDA or BJP. I would like to say RSS is considered to be a very, very controversial organization, and Ali and UP happens
no,
to be.
No, I object to this. I object to this.
Anybody who is heading such an organization and has issued a statement like that everybody who is living in this country is a Hindu, I don't think governor is entitled to entertain him in his Raj Bhavan. Secondly, I would like to say governor can play a proactive role at the same time if he feels that law and order as far as his perception, but to take the agenda like he said that Achhe Din and equating it with Achhi Diwali, he's proving to be a mouthpiece of BJP government. And I would like to say that sensitivity is to be there in the part of the governor. We may agree, Gaurav may agree with this or not, that law and order situation is deteriorating, and if at all he has issued a comment, I think he has issued a very realistic position of the state. I don't need your certificate for that.
I don't take certificates, I don't give certificates. What I would like to tell you as an observation is that I thank you for having the honesty to accept that Governor Shankar Narayan digressed, that Governor Bhardwaj digressed, and Governor Kamla Beniwal digressed. You are the first Congress spokesperson who has admitted so.
No, I didn't say that the Governor Shankar Narayan digressed. I simply said these two cases cannot be
equated. No, you first said two wrongs don't make a right, and then you said we do digress sometimes.
I said according to your perception, if at all anything wrong had been done, so that doesn't justify the utterances of the present governor.
What about Kamla Beniwal? Did she digress or not?
No. Kamla Beniwal...
Did Kamla Beniwal digress?
Her perception was what?
Gujarat Assembly passed the Lokayukt bill, she blocked it. What perception? Did she digress? Let me give you an easy one. Shankar Narayanan, did he digress? Did he digress Shankar, when he refused Shankar the CBI Narayan sanction said, no, to prosecute
Ashok
Chavan?
I don't think, Shankar Narayan's perception was, what was his perception?
There was a whole Adarsh committee report. He refused to give sanction to the CBI to prosecute Ashok Chavan in the Adarsh housing scam, leaving the agency no choice but to close the case against him. Did he digress?
If at all he feels that the state machinery had done justice to the investigation, I think he is within his time. He cannot stall it. He cannot block it. But he simply sent it for reconsideration.
He sent it for reconsideration, and I think he is within his rights to. Okay, both the Samajwadi Party and the BJP wanted to counter the Congress Party. Who goes first is the question. I am letting Sambit Patra go first because maximum criticism came for the BJP. After that, I will come to you. You can ask Sambit as many questions as you want. Yes, Sambit Patra. Do you have any substantial point to make?
I do not see any controversy in this whole governor's address. First and foremost, as everyone in the channel also, in the panel also agrees to the fact that the law and order situation in Uttar Pradesh is really bad, and if the governor proactively takes up the subject, and specifically...
He did not take up the law and order subject.
There are so many persons from the BJP who are accused.
He spoke about Agra as well as the law and order situation.
Please understand, on law and order he didn't say anything. He said this is not a problem that can be fixed in a laboratory. It requires continued and prolonged efforts. So on law and order he said nothing. But he used the line Achhe Din.
Tell me one thing, as a political figure, should he take the BJP's line of Achhe Din? As an apolitical figure, should he congratulate the BJP central government?
Something that goes far beyond the ambit of the office he holds?
You did not get.
Should he defy the Supreme Court?
It depends on how you see.
Should he defy the Supreme Court?
Arnav?
No, you tell me, Sambit.
Arnav, if you allow.
You tell me, Sambit, is there any denying? Okay, one question.
Yes, how will I tell if you don't allow me to?
No, I'll let you, but you understand my question because I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask my question five times for you to answer it.
I understood your question.
What is my question?
I have connected to the program.
No, you've not connected.
Let me complete.
You please listen to the question. You listen to the question again.
Achhe din is a very common term.
Oh.
Achhe din is a very common term. Anyone can use achhe din.
No, don't try to fool the nation.
Okay.
Mr. Sambat, don't try to fool the nation.
Kamal Farooqi says you are fooling.
Don't try to fool the nation.
Aam Aadmi thousand times.
Don't try to fool the nation.
Mr.
Sambat.
The Congress.
No, don't try to fool the nation.
No, Sambat, don't fool the nation.
Don't try to fool the nation.
Working for the Aam Aadmi.
No, Sambit. Kamal Farooqi.
Don't try to fool the nation, Mr. Sambat.
BJP is just towing the line of Bharatiya Janata Party.
Lured by the argument of Mr. Sambit Patra and no one else. Everyone else can read between the message.
I have a question for Sambit Patra.
No, before that, Kamal Farooqi.
I have a question for Sambit Patra. What is a governor in Gujarat doing?
Ask.
Arnav.
There have been communal riots in Gujarat.
Arnav, just one.
Over the last 10 days, the communal situation in Gujarat has been really bad.
Mr. Khaitan, please allow me.
What is the governor of Gujarat doing?
Mr. Khaitan, no, 1 second. 1 second. Mr. Khaitan, 1 minute.
Please allow me.
1 minute. I am allowing Kamal Farooqi.
What about achieving for people in Gujarat?
I am allowing Kamal Farooqi, please. He's been waiting. Kamal Farooqi. Kamal Farooqi was the first person who interjected and accused Sambit Patra of fooling the nation. He says Sambit Patra is fooling the nation.
Mr. Sampath.
Yeah.
No, who is saying that? Who is saying that?
Mr. Sampath. Mr. Sampath. Mr. Sampath, there is no need.
No, who is saying that?
I am saying it. Kamal Farooqi, I am saying it. Don't try to fool the nation because everybody knows.
Why are you saying that? Why are you saying that?
Because you said that you have to read. There is absolutely no problem as well as Chetan Kassan. Absolutely, there is no
problem. Why are you fooling the people of this nation?
No. Please, Sampath. Sampath, please. Masai, we don't need to read in between the lines. What Mr. Nayak has said is very, very abundantly clear. He was talking about the BJP agenda itself. Absolutely. There was no question of reading in between the lines. This is what actually is the objection.
What is that?
He could have said as well because he's a governor. But he cannot take up the BJP agenda.
The presentation of the President of India speaks about
good days in the country. As if you do not know. As if you are very innocent, you do not know about it.
Did he do something wrong?
As if you do not know about it.
If you wish Happy Diwali to the people,
as if you do not know about it.
Did he sin somewhere by wishing Happy Diwali?
Sambit is being so innocent as if he doesn't understand that you are very innocent.
One second, one at a time. One at a time, gentlemen.
In
2010, the Supreme Court, with regard to governors, made it clear that while some of them may come from a political background, once they are appointed as governors, they owe their allegiance and loyalty to the Constitution of India and not to any political party and must preserve, protect and defend the Constitution. My question is this. My question is this. I want to refocus the debate. I want to refocus the debate. My question is this. I'm coming to you, Gaurav. Is there any denying? No. 1 minute. Is there 1 second, Gaurav? Gaurav, let's refocus it. I'm asking a question. Is there any denying that by saying "Achhi Diwali, Achhe Dino Ke Saath, Achhi Diwali, Achhe Dino Ke Saath" aa rahi hai, Ram Nayak sounds like a BJP spokesman rather than an apolitical figure? That is my question. And I think Mr. Sambit Patra cannot be allowed to skirt or deflect around that question. Yes, Gaurav, quickly complete your point, and Vivek also wanted to come in.
Arey, achhe din is achhe din. Arnab,
since you are quoting from the Supreme Court judgment,
you are
now can I speak?
Arnab,
you are Delhi ke logon ke liye achhe din kab aayenge?
Understand this?
A verbal diarrhea.
People of Delhi have achhe din.
Arnab, can you ask Sambit to be quiet so that I can make my point? Otherwise, they will be shouting at each other.
Questioning me. Samajwadi Party, after all, this criminality will not be quiet.
You have held Delhi hostage to Amit Shah's machinations.
Sambit.
Mr. Sambit Patra, you have held Delhi hostage to Amit Shah's machinations.
Don't bring Amit Shah ji over here.
The governor of Delhi and the BJP have been cahoots to deny achhe din to people of Delhi.
Allow others to speak.
Gaurav Bhatia.
Arnab, can I just...
Everywhere you have posted governors...
Arnab, the Supreme Court also said that the governor has to rise above day-to-day politics.
And look at the conduct of the governor of Delhi.
He cannot be an agent or employee of the central government.
Look at the conduct of the governor of Delhi.
The point that I want to make
is
that the chief minister, Mr. Akhilesh Yadav, has been meeting the governor.
As far as the governor of Delhi is concerned,
if there is any concern that the governor has,
for saying that he is the agent of Congress, after few days you start saying that he is the agent of BJP,
and we are sure that after he gets the
why don't you feel that he is the agent of Congress, which is not befitting of the office that he holds.
So this is very vital that he does not politicize the office that he is holding, and there is no extra constitutional person acting like another chief minister in the state.
You know Gaurav Bhatia, the other thing which I have heard is something else. I didn't want to completely reveal the reason why you are upset with Ram Naik.
You may.
But since you are taking
Now has always been good in presenting half-baked facts. So you can tell me.
No half-baked facts at all, Gaurav.
That happened in Badayu rape case. Did
no half-baked
Arnav,
facts.
Arnav, I have a question for Gaurav.
No. One second. Is it true? Is it true that the real reason you are upset with Ram Naik is because Ram Naik has stalled an attempt to elevate the state status of an acolyte of Azam Khan called Shakil Ahmad and give him the status of a cabinet minister as minority panel chief? And 1 minute, let me complete, please, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia. Now that I'm beginning to tell you the truth,
please do.
You are getting shaky.
I'm not interrupting you.
You are getting shaky, and the governor has actually said that reconsider that ordinance in your case, because I want to know what is the urgency of bringing apart an ordinance to give this man cabinet minister status when the chairman of the minority commission has been working without the status of cabinet minister for 20 years since 1994. What on earth is your terrifying hurry to give this man a cabinet minister status? And you are so desperate to give this man, Shakil Ahmad, the rank of a cabinet minister that you scurried and stealthily brought this in through an ordinance. And this is the same man, by the way, Gaurav Bhatia, and I'm glad that I have silenced you now. Gaurav, I have the moral right to ask the question to the BJP, not you. He's the same man whose credentials were questioned.
To answer your question.
You see, I find it very interesting. You see, till this point, till the point I'm agreeing with Gaurav Bhatia and questioning the BJP, Gaurav Bhatia is fine. The moment I ask him a question, then he says, you are good at misrepresenting facts. Just look at the manner in which Gaurav Bhatia is changing his line.
No,
now, the fact is, you wanted to hurriedly make... You are not interested in governance. You want to give cabinet minister rank to people.
Can I answer your question?
Ram Naik has also
spoken about... First.
Okay,
can
answer.
I answer.
Can I add one question to your kitty?
No, one second. Just a minute. Let him answer. Let Gaurav Bhatia answer this one.
Stands exposed.
Yeah, Gaurav Bhatia.
Samajwadi Party stands exposed today. Now, anyone who tries to show the mirror to Samajwadi Party, in fact, is reprimanded by the Samajwadi Party. Today the fact is clear.
I want to answer your question only if you can regulate the debate and ask Sambit to be quiet. At least be
don't get worked up.
Right. You were speaking all this while when Arnav was speaking, and when I am questioning you want me to be quiet. Shouldn't I speak the truth about Samajwadi Party?
Your question is.
I'll also ask one more line because I want to completely expose you on this one.
Yeah.
One sec. I did not want to at this stage, but I feel that since you are taking such a high moral ground, I need to completely expose you.
You
see, on the 7th of October, listen to me, because I don't get worked up. On the 7th of October,
don't allow me to answer your question.
Don't get worked up.
I think you are trying to make sure that truth doesn't come out.
Gaurav, on this, truth will come out. Now let me put out some more truth. On the 7th of October, Ram Naik praises Mulayam Singh Yadav and compares his achievements and strength to that of Lord Hanuman. Right? Should he be considered a stooge of the BJP if he was comparing Mulayam Singh Yadav to Lord Hanuman? So you compare Mulayam Singh Yadav to Lord Hanuman, you're a very nice governor. Okay. Now, the moment, and you allow all, you allow Yogi Adityanath to carry out all the polarization before the elections, of which many people believe not just the BJP but the Samajwadi Party is a beneficiary because it's a got-up game between the both of you. You're a very nice governor. The moment you stop your political appointee from getting the position of cabinet minister, suddenly.
Any leader who was trying to communalize the election, we took strict action. We arrested.
Oh, I know how much strict
BJP
action you took
in Muradabad.
I know how much strict action you took.
Communal feeling.
I know how much strict action.
I am unable to come out of the shock that Mulayam
BJP and SP have been involved in competitive communalism in UP.
No. One more question to Gaurav Bhatia. No. Gaurav Bhatia, since Gaurav Bhatia says I don't want to pursue the truth, let me ask him if he has the confidence.
And the accountability
and the morality to accept a few truthful questions today. My next question to you, Gaurav Bhatia, is this.
5-minute question.
Gaurav Bhatia, 10-second question. 10-second question to completely demolish you. 10-second question, completely demolishing your argument.
First, I will answer your first question.
No, I'll first give you one question. You won't have any answers left after that.
Allow me to answer your first question.
One question. One more question.
It's not done. It's not fair. It's not good journalism.
Now you start telling me what's good journalism.
Have the patience to hear the answer.
I'll ask you only one question. 20 seconds. Don't be so nervous.
Have the patience to hear the answer.
20-second question. Don't be so nervous. 20-second question. Okay, 1 minute. Got up. I'll give you full time. Answer this question. One last question. Is it true? Is it true?
I will answer your first question. I will answer your first question first.
Why not another question?
Yes, I will answer.
Why not
first
one more question?
First.
One question. I'm asking you one more question. I'm not asking you for your permission. My question is: Is it true? And viewers can see if Gaurav Bhatia is trying to stop me from asking my question because he thinks he will have no legs left to stand on after that. Gaurav Bhatia, my next question to you is this. Is it true that your government has taken no action against corruption despite the Lokayukta recommending action against 14 persons, including 4 mantris, 4 ministers and 8 officers between January and September 2014? What action did you take against the 4 ministers and 8 officers against whom the Lokayukta recommended action for corruption between January and September 2014?
Because I'm waiting to answer the first question first. I will answer the first question, then you ask me the second question.
Oh, yes. Sure you will.
And the answer to your first question is this.
He doesn't have the answer for the second question.
There is no animosity between the chief minister and the governor. We hold him in high regard. And if he needs any information, just the way...
Look how you're backing off now.
In the past, there have been meetings between the chief minister and the governor.
Oh, so you want to settle things behind closed doors.
Information which would in fact clarify his doubts. And I think that should
look how
be
you're
the way
backing
to
off
move
now.
Forward, working within the framework of the Constitution and not trying to cross the line. That is the point I want to make. And your
Sambit Patra.
The party stands completely exposed.
Let me clarify that there is no.
I mean, they are sticking
the
on to two words, Achhe Din. But look at the kind of work they are doing. They are not doing Achhe work. They are only sticking to these words, Achhe Din.
He may continue.
Gaurav Bhatia,
I don't know
you
what
should be doing
Achhe
work.
Can
achhe
you not have the patience to
should
listen
not be
first.
Focusing on the literal meaning
I really
of Achhe Din.
That
I mean, you stand
you
completely exposed.
The Lokayukta's
recommendations are not taken into force. You want to go into appeasement policy by giving a cabinet rank.
Gaurav Bhatia, now you will stop at this moment, and I'm requesting you. You will stop, and I think you see. Once I'm reducing volume, I want to say something to the viewers. You see, this tactic must stop. This tactic must stop. And I'm saying this openly, Gaurav, I'm making an observation, you must stop. And please hear me for a minute. You see, this tactic must stop. I ask a question, and because the question does not want... And Gaurav, just listen, please. You know, don't go on. Gaurav, please. You see, when I ask a question, you can answer. Don't want to answer? Say, I don't want to answer. Want to deflect? Say, I want to deflect. Want to duck? Want to duck? Say, I want to duck. Don't have the facts. Say I don't have the facts. But don't go on and on and on while I'm asking the question, so that you pretend you never heard it.
Regarding the ordinance, the governor has the power to send it back. The government may reconsider and send it back to the
Did you take action against 4 ministers and 8 officers against whom? Now listen to me. Did you take action, yes or no, against 4 ministers and 8 officers against whom the Lokayukta recommended action on the charges of corruption? And is it true the governor sent 2 letters on this issue?
I am telling you, Arnab, there are more than 10 ex-ministers against whom we have taken action on the...
Did you take action against four ministers and eight officers against whom Ram Nayak recommended action and the governor, office of the governor recommended action between January and September 2014, yes or no?
I am telling you, the state government has taken action against more than 10 ministers on the recommendation made by the Lokayukta.